In this series, we're going to explain what a fix is, what a course line is, how to take a fix, various methods of taking a fix, how to use an estimated position, and dead reckoning, or determining where you'll be in a little while, or where you are when you can't take a fix. We'll determine our set and drift from tide, wind, and currents, and how to utilize that to stay on course. We'll put everything together in the end and do an example Gulfstream crossing from Florida to the Bahamas. Let's get started. The next thing we need to learn is how to determine set, drift, course to steer, CTS, and speed made good, SMG. Using the tools and the basic training we've had with latitude, longitude, compass, and plotting, let's see if we can work that out. It's 8 o'clock in the morning and we take a fix. We find that our latitude is 28.20 north. And our longitude is 080-30-00 west. We find those on the chart. Left-hand side or right-hand side of the chart, we find our latitude of 28.20, and we draw a line at that position, roughly where we think our longitude is. And we find our longitude, do the same thing, cross-hatch those, and mark our fix. We've written the time, latitude, and longitude. Normally, we would write our heading and our ship speed as well. Here's our DR position. This is where we want to be. Let's see if we can figure out how to get there and what time we should get there. First, we use our parallel rules, or our protractor rule, to draw a course line and determine that course on our compass rows of 3, 4, 2, true. Remember, we plot on charts using true north. So our DR position will be 3, 4, 2, true from our current position. We're going 5 knots. We've measured with our dividers 2.7 nautical miles. So we need to determine when we're going to get there. So we use distance, speed, and time math. Distance divided by speed equals time. Distance divided by time equals speed. And speed times time equals distance. You can write it like this, with distance, a line, and then speed and time divided, just to keep it clear. So our distance of 2.7 nautical miles divided by our speed of 5 knots gives us a time of 0.54 hours. 0.54 hours doesn't really work very well for us determining what time we're going to get there, so we need to convert that to minutes. 0.54 hours times 60. We simply multiply by 60 to get minutes from tenths of hours, and that comes out to 32.4 minutes, or approximately 32 minutes. Since it's 8 o'clock in the morning, our ETA is 32 minutes from now, which will be 08:32. So we should be at our DR position at 08:32. We know it's going to be about a half an hour, but 8:30, we take another position fix. We get our latitude on the left, our longitude on the right. We mark our position at 8:30 of 28.2200 north, 080-32-00 west, and we find we are here. We missed. We're not at our DR position. That's because of set and drift. Assuming, of course, we maintained our proper heading on our ship. So what is set and drift? Set is the direction we're pushed off course. Drift is the amount of distance or speed we're pushed off course. We take our trusty parallel rules, draw a line between DR position and our actual position at 8:30. We parallel over to our compass and we find our set is 325 true, a southwest set. We measure with our dividers between the two points, go find our distance on the latitude, comes out to 0.6 nautical miles. Distance is 0.6 nautical miles divided by 0.5 hours equals 1.2 knots. Our set is southwest at 235 degrees true north. Our drift is 1.2 knots. The actual distance we covered in a half an hour was 2.6 nautical miles. Our course made good, that's the course we actually ended up going, not necessarily the course we steered, is 318 true north. So our course made good, our CMG, is 318 true north. Our speed made good was 5.2 knots. 2.6 nautical miles divided by 0.5 hours comes out to 5.2 knots. Let's figure out how we can compensate for this in the future so we can determine a course to take in order to end up in the right place. We need to make a conversion to compensate for set and drift. In order to end up at our dead reckoning position where we want to be, we need to maintain 3-4-2 true. We take our course line and we draw it on our compass rows. 3-4-2 true. Then we draw our set line, 235 true. So we're going to take our drift of 0.6 nautical miles and mark that on our set line. So remember, again, our drift is 1.2 knots, but in 30 minutes, our distance would only be 0.6 nautical miles. or half of that. We take our dividers, measure the distance between our last known position and our current position, which is 2.6 nautical miles. We can measure that on our latitude. We put one end of the divider, one point of the divider, is placed right on the drift distance mark on our set line. The other end of our divider is swung around until it perfectly matches our course line. That red line denotes the two points of our dividers. 2.6 nautical miles in distance gives us a mark on our course line. We take our parallel rules, line them up on the red line, slide them over to the center of our compass rose, and draw a line. That line from the center of our compass is our course to steer, 355 true. The course to steer, 355 true, is the course we need to steer our boat in order to actually make a course made good of 342 degrees in order to end up in our planned dead reckoning position. So basically our set and drift is pushing us southwest, and what we've done is determine the proper course to head a little bit northeast so that we arrive at our dead reckoning position.